Harrington. What's he up to these days? Still busting up bars and breaking hearts?
Well, he's recently come into a great deal of money. You may have read about it in the papers.
Oh, I did. And if I know Ben, he'll gamble it away. Every dollar.
You knew him quite well, didn't you?
He was one of my best customers.
Thank you. Did you know him around the time of the fire?
Honey, I've known him since the day he was 15 years old to the day he left home. He used to raise a lot of hell. Not a bad sort, though.
Was he here the day of the fire?
Not that I know of.
Think back carefully. You sure he wasn't with one of your girls when the fire broke out?
Why are you asking?
It's in Ben's best interest that I find out. You see, all that money that he won at the trial is in danger of being taken away from him. Now, he could protect himself if he gives the lady's name. But he's being noble.
Ben? Noble? Must be a different Ben. Unless he's had a personality transplant in the last 20 years.
Well, be that as it may, it's of great concern to me to find out where Ben was the day of the fire.
He wasn't here.
Any idea where he was? That's the last one.
I don't know where he was. You see, by that time, he'd fallen in love. With an amateur. They used to meet on the other side of the town.
Who? Who was she?
How should I know? He never told me. Too noble, I guess.
Are you sure? You said yourself that nobility isn't one of his strong points.
All he ever said was that she was married. It was some big secret.
Married to whom?
I don't know. Some Colorado big shot, I think. Prominent family, plenty of money. I had to hand it to Ben, though, for keeping it all a secret. Even if it did lose me a lot of business.
But you never knew her name?
Sorry.
No. You've been a great help. Thank you.
You busy?
Yes, I am. Regrettably.